In this video, we will take a closer look at this leather case for the iPhone 11 Pro. This is, of course, the genuine leather case from Apple with MagSafe. These cases have just gotten pretty expensive here throughout the years. And you can see it here compared to my 11 Pro Max case that I still have lying around. It's not quite black, even though this is the midnight color compared to, of course, the black color on the 11 Pro Max here. It is more of a bluish hue, but it's a very dark blue, like almost navy blue. And you can see the install instructions here on the back side, as of course the specifications and the name of the cover. It kind of have to squeeze it in the left side first, and then of course in the right side second, at least according to these instructions here. And yeah, like I said, this is the Pro leather case, midnight color, and this is the closest you can get to black color this year. A little bit unfortunate. I really like the black one. Not really too big a fan of dark blue. But anyways, let's just unbox it and have a closer look and, of course, install it on the phone. And, of course, what you get in the box is the leather case itself, as well as some paperwork. And you can also see there in the back of the case as well, there is the same instruction. So put it in left side first and then squeeze it into the right side of the case. Of course, the phone there. So yeah, let's try that as well. And of course, you can see some further instructions here on the little piece of cardboard that is supposed to go inside the case, and a little safety instruction guide list as well. So yeah, definitely a little bit of paperwork, but of course, that's not really anything you need to get this working. It's just a simple cover. It seems to be a little bit damaged down here in the corner, but this is those leather cases, and the smell test definitely confirms that this is a leather case. So they will vary a little bit in style and, of course, in fabric, or not in fabric, but in pattern of the leather fabric here. Of course, you do have the aluminium button here for the power button on the left side, as well as aluminium buttons on the, this is the left side and the other button is on the right side. And this is, of course, the volume rocker there. And of course, you also have room for the mute switch as well. So I really like this design here with those aluminium buttons. I believe it was like the 10 series that they started doing that. And of course, you have cutouts here in the bottom for charging and speaker and microphone. And that big button there again on the right side for power and Siri and Apple Pay. And that multifunction button there, of course, you will have to use that quite a bit to turn off your phone and to use Apple Pay. And this is, of course, a MagSafe case. So I do have a magnet inside here of this ring, which is kind of a neat feature. I've not really found any useful case for it as of yet for me personally. But you can see here my stainless steel knife can definitely hold up this case because of that magnet here in the back. But I've seen people use it for car mounts and tripod mounts and such for their phones, but I've not really used for that personally. But it's a nice feature to have and maybe something I'll use in the future. And you can see here inside they have a soft fabric, so you won't scratch your phone even if there is some dust and stuff when you actually install this case. It will not rub against your phone and scratch it with time. And here the color between the black 11 Pro Max case that I still have lying around here and the midnight, you can see it definitely is more towards the dark blue, but you can only really see it when you actually are comparing between a dark or black case, in this case here on the right, between the midnight. And of course, if the light is hitting the case at certain angles, it does look a little bluish hue, have a little bit of bluish hue, excuse me. But it's not really all that hard and all that bad in my opinion. And like I said, only really if you compare, you really notice the bluish hue. And one of the reasons why I wanted to throw a case on my 11 Pro is it's just such a fingerprint magnet. It just looks awful. This is only after a few days of usage. I was planning to just carry this naked without any case, but as soon as I saw all those fingerprints, it's just, yeah, not really the best look. And also the edges are a little bit sharp, so I hope that this case will make it a little bit softer to actually hold in my hand. And as always, when I am replacing my case, I will wipe down my phone, so there will not be any dust or anything like that accumulating or inside the case with the phone. And then, of course, the left side first, and you do have to quite use a lot of force to actually get the phone in. Feels almost like you're gonna break something, but once it's in, you're definitely not getting the phone out accidentally. You need to put a lot of force to actually get this phone out. So yeah, it looks kind of nice. Like I said, I would rather have liked the all black case like the previous generation, but this definitely looked kind of black when you're not comparing it to other cases. And it does feel quite nice in the hand, does have a little bit of softer touch and a little more rounded corners. So if you don't like the squarish design of the newer iPhones, definitely get a case on, or put a case on your phone. This is definitely always my preferred ones, the leather one from Apple. And of course, weight-wise here, 229 with the case installed on the 13 Pro. So definitely not a lightweight phone at all, but I've gotten so used to heavy phones, so I don't really notice it at all. And of course, you have that big camera cut out with nice protection all the way around. So you do have a lip around the camera, so the phone won't lie flat on the table, but not really an issue in my opinion. And it's always nice to keep those lenses protected. As you can see here, they do not protrude anymore. So the case will definitely keep those protected. Buttons feel nice. You do have to use it for a week or so, or at least a few days for the button to be a little looser. But in the beginning, they can be a little bit stiff, but they will loosen up over time. And of course, perfectly cut out here for the speaker's microphone and the Agent lightning cable, that USB 2.0 cable, a plug on a professional phone. It's a little ridiculous. But anyways, on the left side here, of course, you have the volume rockers. Same thing on the other side there. After a few days, they will be a little bit easier to press the buttons. And you also still can get a nail in there and actually mute that little toggle there as well. So quite nice. And it feels excellent in the hand. I like that leather feel, and it will age quite nicely, in my opinion at least. Always the case I will go for on Apple for iPhones, but definitely has gotten more expensive throughout the years. Not really sure it's worth it though, but for me it definitely is. But in terms of value, it is definitely not the best out there. And you can see there is some wobble when you are pressing quite hard up in the left corner of your phone, but else it actually lays pretty flat, so you should not have any problem actually using the phone on the table. And you do have a raised lip all the way around the screen, so if you lay the screen down, you should not have any issues with scratching or anything like that, so definitely well protected. But I actually ended up upgrading to a Pro Max, 13 Pro Max from the regular 13 Pro. I really wanted to try a smaller phone, but I just ended up longing for that bigger screen. Gotten so used to Max phones, and I have an S21 Ultra as well, so big screen phones is definitely for me. So I ended up, like I said, getting the Max instead, and I exchanged that leather case for the Max leather case. Same exact color, so let's just have a closer look and see if there's any differences. Of course, same install instructions here on the back, left side in first, and then you just squeeze in the right side. And this is, of course, like I said, the midnight color as well, which is the closest to black. And inside the case, exactly the same. Surprise, surprise, same instructions, same paperwork, and everything. And of course, the case is exactly the same, and the cost exactly the same as well, even though this is actually a little bit bigger. And same buttons, same cutouts, same raised camera bump here on the back. Everything is the same. So let's just wipe down my 13 Pro Max this time around. Make sure there's no dust and no fingerprints or anything like that when I will install it into this case. And of course, just squeeze it in the left side first and the right side second, and use a little bit of force to get it in there. Definitely a case you will not have to or not want to switch out often, because it's hard to get the phone out. But anyways, you are looking at 269 grams with the case installed on the 13 Pro Max. And actually, compared to my S21 Ultra with this Rocket case, it's about 10 grams lighter. Kind of surprised me a little bit, because the 13 Pro has gotten a little heavier compared to the previous generations. But exactly the same else, also the same color phone I have. So I have the gray phone and the midnight case, and you can see the lenses are still nicely protected inside this case. And it will also still, of course, wobble a little bit when you have it on the table and if you are pressing up in the left corner. But definitely not an issue if you are pressing lightly on the phone. You shouldn't really have any problem with it wobbling. And yeah, I really like the feel of this case. Definitely makes the phone much more comfortable in your hand, especially the large one here, with the little bit more rounded colors and soft touch feel. I really like the leather feel in my hand. Same kinds of buttons here, of course, aluminium buttons, as well as the non-Pro Max variant, or non-Max variant rather. And of course, you still have access there to the mute switch, so you can easily mute your phone. And like I said, the camera there are nicely protected inside the case. and the buttons do have to be used a few times or a few days for it to actually be a little easier to press. Not really that hard to begin with, but it does get a little bit better over time. And the same cutout perfectly here on the bottom for the speaker, microphone, and of course that aging lightning plug there as well. And in hand feel, excellent, like I said. Really like the leather feel on my skin, and this case definitely is going to last a long time. It is also an expensive case, and like I said, it is hard actually to get the phone out of the case, so make sure you don't really want to swap out the case often with this one here, but I highly recommend it, and of course you can find affiliate link down in the description below. But that's pretty much it for this video. I hope to see you again in a future one. Until then, take care.